Hello everyone, in this video we're going to learn how to install and configure Squid Proxy server on a LAN. Squid is a powerful proxy solution that helps manage internet access, enhance security, and optimize bandwidth usage for your system. Before we get started, let's take a look at the network diagram we'll be working with. Here, the internet connects to the router slash firewall through the WAN port, and then the LAN is distributed from this router. Inside the LAN, we have a Squid Proxy server, and the client machines will connect through this proxy to access the internet. This is a basic setup that helps manage traffic, improve security, and optimize bandwidth for the local network. All right, let's get started. First, open the terminal window on your system. Before we begin, let's check some basic information on your system, such as the hostname and IP address. This will make it easier to manage and configure the server correctly. For the IP address, I recommend assigning a static IP to your server. Next, before installing Squid, we need to update the package list and the system to make sure everything is up to date. Next, we'll install Squid Proxy server using the following command. After the installation, start the Squid Proxy service and enable it to automatically run at system startup. Now let's navigate to the Squid configuration directory. This is where the main configuration file is located, and we'll be editing it shortly. Before making any changes, let's back up the default configuration file. This allows us to restore it easily if something goes wrong. Make sure that the backup file has been created in the configuration directory. Now, let's open the Squid configuration file to start editing. You can use the Vim editor or any text editor you prefer. Now, delete all the default content inside the Squid file. This will prevent confusion and keep the configuration file clean. Next, we'll add the sample configuration I've prepared. This is a basic setup for Squid Proxy to work within the LAN. First, enter your server's hostname here. This line makes Squid display the correct hostname in logs and makes it easier to manage. Next, we'll create an ACL named MyNet. This ACL defines the network range of your LAN, so Squid knows which clients are allowed to connect. If you have multiple LAN subnets, you can define them under the same ACL name. Next, we'll configure Squid to allow the subnets defined in the MyNet ACL to access the internet through the proxy. After that, we'll deny all other access outside of the MyNet ACL. This enhances security by ensuring that only the LAN subnets you allow can use the proxy. By default, Squid Proxy server listens on port 3128 for incoming connections. However, you can change it to another port if needed. Here, we configure the amount of RAM that Squid server can use for caching. Typically, this value is set to 1/3 of the physical RAM of the server, or more if you want better performance. Finally, we define the amount of disk space Squid will use for long-term caching. This parameter is important because it determines how much data Squid can store on the disk. Now copy the entire sample configuration and paste it into the squid.conf file we opened early. Finally, after editing and pasting the configuration, save and exit the file. Next, to apply the changes in the configuration file, restart the Squid Proxy server service. Then, check the service status to make sure Squid is running properly. If the status shows active, it means that the Squid Proxy server has been successfully configured and is now running properly on your system. As we configured, Squid Proxy server is listening on port 3128. If your system has a firewall enabled, you need to add a rule to allow this port so that LAN clients can connect. If the firewall status is inactive, it means your system is not using a firewall. In this case, you can skip this step. Now, allow port 3128 on your firewall so that Squid Proxy can accept connections from LAN clients. At this point, we've basically finished installing and configuring the Squid Proxy server on the server machine. Next, let's move on to a Windows computer to configure and test the connection through the proxy. On your Windows computer, open the control panel. Next, click on Internet Options. In the new window that appears, go to the Connections tab. Then click the LAN Settings button. In the Local Area Network LAN Settings window, check Use a Proxy Server for your LAN and Bypass Proxy Server for local addresses. Next, in the Address field, enter the IP address of your Squid Proxy Server. In the Port field, enter 3128, or the port you configured. Finally, click OK to save, and then click OK again to close the Internet Options window. Now, open a web browser on your Windows computer and try accessing any website. If the connection is successful, it means that all traffic is being routed through the Squid Proxy server. And that's it. We've successfully installed and configured Squid Proxy server on the LAN, and also tested it from a Windows machine. This is the basic step to deploy a proxy system for your business or home network, not in Hitchin. In the upcoming videos, we'll explore more advanced features, such as blocking access to unwanted websites, managing file downloads, and setting up user authentication. Stay tuned so you don't miss out.